हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम कुंवरी रेश, स्टूडेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट इन यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लखनऊ. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट ए शॉर्ट प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन माय टॉपिक ब्लास्ट रेजिस्टेंट बिल्डिंग. दीज आर द कंटेंट्स हाउ वी विल प्रोसीड इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. सो नाउ these pictures of blasts are enough to predict up to how much extent a building and humans inside a building can be affected. As we know, a need or a problem encourages creative efforts to meet the need. So these are the some points which shows the need of the blast. The increasing number of terrorist attacks, especially in the last few years, has shown that the effect of blast load on building is a serious matter. To minimize the loss of life and structural loss, the design should be considered, and also to protect historical and important monuments. In simple way, explosion can be defined in very simple. This is sudden release of energy, and this is most popular issue as the new chemicals like ammonium nitrate. Magnitude of the blast is now increasing. This blast load is very different from other loads in many aspects. Nowadays, these designs are applied in modern buildings. These design concepts do not have much research, so this is emerging branch and creates an opportunity for research. So now, there are many type of blasts. Some important type of blasts are shown. Moving vehicle attack, like in Pulwama terrorist attack. Stationary vehicle bomb, exterior attack, arsons, and other different types of blast. So, coming to the type of explosion, basically two types of explosion, unconfined and confined explosion, based on the available space for blast. By these figures, we can understand the difference. Now come to the design part. As mentioned, the dynamic yield stress 25% higher than the minimum static yield stress in reinforcing steel. Similarly, in also concrete, the dynamic cube compressive strength is 25% higher than the minimum static compressive strength at 28 days. Designs. Now come to the design stress of plain concrete. Dynamic flexural strength of a plain brick and stone masonry to be assumed to be the same as the corresponding static strength. This is simple line. Now come to the main two points. For unreinforced brickwork, the ductility ratio limited to 1.5, and reinforced brickwork it will not the less than 0.05% steel on each face and not more than the balance percentage. Now come to the important part, bomb proof concrete. To make the bomb proof concrete, there are some important points we should keep in mind while making concrete. High cement content, low water binder ratio, and uses fine silica as its only aggregate. And this graph shows how the blast wave pressure travels with the time. In this figure, we can see there is a positive phase and negative phase, and the area of this graph in positive phase shows the specific impulse. And short and straight steel fibers with high compression and tensile strength in the region of 1800 and 2000 Newton per mm square respectively. Now come to the effect of blast on the structure. There is some component of a blast load like thermal energy radiation, audible blast, air blast, dynamic pressure, overpressure. All these types of blasts are clear with their names. Now there is a sequence of a air blast effect. First one, blast wave break windows, exterior walls, column. Then blast wave forces floor upward. And finally, the blast wave surrounded structure downward pressure on the roof. So there is a definition of an explosion: a rapid release of potential energy, as I told, and a part of this energy is converted into thermal energy, which is shown as flash, and part is coupled as air blast and shock wave, which expand radially in all directions. Now come to the principle of blast resistant design. Basically, the main concept is standoff zones. This is maintain the safe separation of attacks and targets, avoid progressive collapse and building, allow for the limited localized damage, designed to sustain certain amount of bomb damage, and also minimize the quantity and hazard of broken glass and blast induced debris. Facilitate the rescue and recovery operation at the time of blast also. There is a different aspects of design. Let's talk about the first, the architectural aspect. Planning and layout. The planning and layout is that aspect to reduce the threat and to create the standoff zones in the buildings. Next one, structural form and internal layout. Basically, structural form is a parameter that greatly affects the blast loads on the building. Arches and domes are the type of structural forms that reduce the blast effect. It should be noted that single-story buildings are more blast-resistant compared with the multi-story building. And the other one, internal layout of the building is another parameter and should be arranged so that the highest exterior threat is separated by the greatest distance from the highest value asset. And the next one, bomb shelter areas. Within the building, vulnerability from explosion is minimum. They are located away from doors, windows and roof. If roof is weak, basement can be useful shelter areas also. And now installations. So gas, water, steam installation, electrical connections, elevators and water storage systems should be planned to resist any explosion effect. Installation connections are critical points. Areas with high damage receiving potential, for example, external walls, ceilings, roof slab, car parking spaces and lobbies also should be avoided to locate the electrical and other installations. The main control units and installation feeding points should be protected from the direct attacks. And the last one, glazing and cladding. Glass from the broken and the shattered window could be responsible for a large number of injuries. The choice of a safer glazing material is critical, and it has been found out that laminated glass is the most effective in this context. On the other hand, applying transparent polyester anti-shatter film to the inner surface of the glazing is as well an effective method. And now for the cladding, the amount of glazing in the facade could be minimized. This will limit the amount of internal damage from the glazing and the amount of blast that can enter. It should also be ensured that the cladding is fixed to the structure securely with easily accessible fixings. This will allow the rapid inspection after an explosion so that any failure or movement can be detected. These are the systematic layout of a site for protection against bomb. And this is the internal planning of a building. We can see there is a standoff zone and high risk area is separated from the main building. Now come to the structural aspect. So, blast loading are extraordinary load cases. It is not like a dead load or live load. So, effect should be taken into account with other loads by an adequate ratio. Blast resistance design also uses the LSM method, which are collapse limit design and functionality limit design. In collapse, the target is to provide enough ductility, and in case of explosion, significant translational movement and movement occur, and the loads involved should be transferred from beams to the columns properly. So with these figures, we can understand the difference between the blast and the seismic load. As we see, the blast load above ground and below ground, how the load occurs on the structure. and the next figure are the load signature plotted by a graph, pressure and time. It shows the blast is impulse and seismic is cyclic in nature. And these are the structure response in the blast load and seismic load. As we can see, there is a localized response in blast and global response in seismic load. In India, we use IS 4991 for the designing of the blast resistant building. This is the first page of that IS code. For example, the Bangalore has a building which is blast proof. So basic data about basic information about the Bangalore building. This is the Bangalore data center. It covered by the CISF, and this is being built by the Engineering India Limited, that is also called EIL. And the walls of this building is designed to be 50 mm thick. And also there is a chances of flood. So keeping the flood factor, engineers have designed to elevate it to approximate 2.1 meters from the ground level. And it is also a earthquake resistant. And also that is Bangalore is under zone 2 on the earthquake sensitive scale. However, the data center is being built for the zone 3 level. You can read about this building on this link. So now come to the conclusion part. So basic conclusion about the blast resistant building is to prevent the overall collapse of the structure and also prevent the human and structural loss due to the blast. The magnitude of the explosion and the load caused by it cannot be anticipated perfectly. It is not also practical to design a building as a fully blast resistant, but up to the some extent. And it is also possible to improve the performance of the structure. As I told, this is new area, so there is also opportunities for research and development. These are the references. Thank you.